If you ask us about our favorite destinations in the Philippines, Batanes is definitely somewhere on top. But what is it about Batanes really? Is it the natural beauty? From its rolling hills to boulder beaches, its every corner is breathtaking. Is it the quietness? It may be surrounded by the most turbulent seas, but it enjoys virtually zero crime rate. Or is it the elusiveness? It's the northernmost province in the country, and it takes more than drive to get there. It's distant and has one hell of a temper. You'll be facing the biggest storms if your timing is not right. But if you know your way around, it can be quite easy to get on its good side. A word of caution though, when the time comes that you have to leave, Batanes will break your heart. Hi Tipiters, we are Vince and Josh. And in this video, we'll share with you some practical tips on how to explore Batanes easily. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new travel videos. How to get there? The fastest and easiest way to reach Batanes is by air. Basco has an airport located in the town proper. Travel time is 70 to 110 minutes depending on your choice of airline and departure point. Fares to Basco are notorious for being expensive. Year-round fares can cost more than 10,000 pesos per way if you book at the last minute. But there are ways to save more. Here are some of them. 1. Fly from Clark. Flights from Clark Airport are significantly cheaper than from Manila. 2. Book a Tuesday or Wednesday flight. The cost of flights to Basco scheduled on these days are considerably lower than other days, while return flights are cheaper on Fridays and Saturdays. 3. Watch out for seat sales. Promo fares to Batanes are rare, but they exist. You just need to catch them when they're up for grabs. Follow airlines on social media so you'll be the first to know when a big Basco sale is about to happen. Or like the Poor Traveler on Facebook, because we usually share sales and other promos on our page. You can find more tips in our Batanes travel guide on our written blog, www.thepoortraveler.net, or follow the link in the description below. When is the best time to visit? As with many other destinations in the Philippines, your best bet is from December to May, which is generally considered dry season. January to February is my favorite period because I've always enjoyed a cooler atmosphere.
The view is amazing. Like, let me show you. Look around us. We have the sea and the rocks, and the wind, and the sun all coming together. This is Batanes at its prettiest.
Completely surrounded by vast bodies of water, including the mighty Pacific to its east, Batanes is known for its crazy weather. It's perfectly normal for the day to begin sunny, rain at around lunchtime, and clear up in the afternoon. Is it okay to book flights for a June to November travel? Of course! Although it is rainy season, it doesn't mean that every day is bad weather day. Just expect rain showers every now and then, but most of them will just pass quickly. My most recent visit happened in November, and although it rained for an hour on our first day, the rest of our time was bright and sunny. It is important to note that the strongest typhoons that hit Batanes in recent memory all did in August to September. Where to stay? Batanes has three main islands: Bataan Island, Sabtang Island, and Itbayat Island. Sabtang and Itbayat are their own municipalities, but Bataan Island is further divided into four municipalities: Basco, Ivana, Uyugan, and Bahataw. As the commercial and economic center of the province, Basco is a good base for tourists. Although it is the capital, Basco isn't a city but a small town. It is also where the main airport is located and the most populated. Inns and homestays are heavily concentrated in the Poblacion area. Tour operators also have their offices here. The cheapest options are homestays. Two popular homestays are Troy's Lodge, where we stayed for the first time, and Marfal's Lodge, which is a favorite among travel bloggers. How to get around? Within Bataan Island, the bicycle is the cheapest way of going around, but make sure you have the stamina to match. The landscape is rugged, and the bicycle ride can take you up and down the slopes of rolling hills 100 times over. Bicycle rental rates vary greatly. It ranges from 25 pesos per day for old bikes to over 600 pesos for mountain bikes. For those who have a driver's license and can drive two wheels, the motorcycle is a good option too. Motorcycle rent costs 500 to 1,000 per day. Gas is not yet included. For those who can't drive or bike, the tricycle is the most usual mode of transportation. You can book one for a full day tour. This is great if you're a party of two or more because you can split the costs. The good thing about this is that the driver already knows where to go or has bits of local information about the place. The rate is usually 200 pesos per hour. Given the time it takes to tour these zones, here are the estimated and the usual trike rates, good for two persons. Note that the rates for Sabtang Island cover only the tour within the island. Not included are the boat ride and the tricycle transfers from Basco to Ivana Port and back. You can also join a group tour. Numerous travel agencies and hotels offer tours, but the one that we have personally tried on our most recent visit was Bisumi Tours, a duly licensed local tour operator based in Basco. This way, you're not just looking at random rolling hills, you're also learning about their significance in the lives of the locals. Here are the rates per person when we visited. Each booking is inclusive of the following: where to eat. Batanes may not be famous as a food destination, but it would be a shame to not sample local cuisine on your visit. It is not for everyone though. The province's natural environment is relatively harsh, narrowing the variety of dishes and ingredients used. Seafood is a staple, and yam or gabi and turmeric or luyang dilaw are widely used. A traditional meal is also often wrapped in a leaf of the antipolo tree. Some of the native dishes include uved, which is ground banana corn with fish or meat shaped into balls, bunes, which is dried gabi stock with fish or meat, lunis, which is salted pork cooked in its own fat, and lobsters, locally called payi, which are ridiculously cheap in Batanes. Coconut crabs, locally called tatus, are also available, but they are already a threatened species, and according to the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources, taking or catching them is illegal, so let's spare the poor crab. These well-known restaurants in Basco offer authentic dishes. Prices usually range from 100 to 300 pesos per person. If you're on a budget, you may try a carinderia, where 50 pesos can give you a good meal. Places to visit. Tourist spots in Batanes are often divided into four zones: North Bataan, South Bataan, Sabtang, and Itbayat. I always recommend taking the North Bataan tour first because it gives just the right dose of what's to come, sort of a teaser. If you're based in Basco, it is the closest and shortest of the tours. The whole thing just takes half a day, around 4 hours. South Bataan takes much longer and covers a wider area and, in my opinion, is much more breathtaking. If you do South Bataan first, the north might leave you a bit underwhelmed. Please take note of the following tourism or environmental fees. We'll not go into the details for now because we'll be creating separate videos about the attractions in Batanes, so watch out for them. That's all for now. If you need more information about traveling to and around Batanes, check out the comprehensive travel guides on our blog, www.theporttraveler.net. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new travel videos. We're Vince and Josh. See you again next time. Plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.